Hello again, the Geeky Minecrafter here with another episode of Let's Play. So, I want to tell you what I did off camera. My house is right over there on the other side of that mountain. You can just barely see the beacon if you get up a little bit. I was out exploring and I found this desert, this kind of, you know, painted area right over here. I was on my way back, actually. I had wandered kind of far, and I saw this spire sitting up, and I thought it was the beacon that I had created on that side of the world, or that side of the hill. So I ran over here, and in doing so, I ran past some really great resources. So here's what I've done off camera. I mean, you know, watching somebody dig dirt is just not a whole lot of fun. So I went in, and I found this mountainside, and I began kind of mining for a few resources here. I moved my hobbit hole, I moved my chest, I basically moved myself over here. And here's what I've done while you were gone. So I came up in here. This has a gorgeous view, some running water. Now these trees weren't here, I did plant these. But it overlooks this little area, this little lagoon here, and it's got a painted desert out here. Lots of clay and stuff that I can use for myself. It's got running water. It's got a giant mountain face. And a quick, you know, a little pool right here that I can probably tap into from inside. So what I did was I just started digging three high, and I dug right straight into the mountain. And once I was in there, I set a few things up. Went right back here. I started right here in this little bitty room. It was just, in the beginning, it was just this. I have built furnaces, added chests, my crafting table. I've got some more chests over here. Now, I have found gold and iron while I was out there mining for cobblestone. I need cobblestone for my project, so I'm gathering that all up. But while I was down there in the mines, I was able to gather some really cool resources. I set up my bed so I can sleep here. And I've discovered that I can plant crops indoors as long as I have enough light and water, and, you know, do like you do outside, just till the dirt. I can actually grow wheat in here. Now, I haven't tried the others, but as soon as I come across them, I will. I've got some additional seeds in here. Let me go ahead and put these up. I have been converting my wheat into bread. See, I have about 10 loaves of bread here. So what I'm doing is I'm creating myself a perpetual food source while I'm down there mining. Now, I was coming out here. I was mining down this way. I was actually considering a couple of more grow rooms and potentially an animal pen down here. And what I discovered, here, let's put this on the wall, was this popped right out. Okay, so now that it's daylight, what I want to do is, hello, Mr. Spider. I want to open this up a little bit so I can kind of see around me. Now, it's still light, so I think he's probably okay. One thing I wanted to do was come in here and mark this so that I could come back with, you know, down here and build some stairs in. But this is a door that can go out to my tree garden. See, I have a bunch of trees that I'm planting out here. So for right now, I'm just going to drop a little cobblestone in here. Come on, we're almost done with the tour. I apologize. But I did get quite a bit done while you were gone, so to speak. Alright, let's put that right here. A spider can't get in one. So let me go back here and see if I have a door, and if not, craft one. I went out and harvested some wood just a little bit ago, so I should have enough for tools. Let's see if I have a door. Oh, I do, right here. So now, doors are potential entry points into my world, and zombies can tear them down. So at night, until I get a piston door, an iron door that they can't break down, at night what I probably am going to do is go ahead and drop a couple of cobblestone, or at least one cobblestone in front of it so the door can't open. That will keep them from being able to come in. Stand outside and make it flush, make it level. Give myself a couple of lights. If I'm going to be coming out here in the dark, you know, should I kill him? I really need the string. With a spider string, you can make a bow. And a bow gives you longevity. A bow gives you some distance. You're going to be able to hit your enemies, without being really, really close to them. And frankly, for some of these enemies, I like that idea. I really do. So let's do this. Let's get a couple of easy ways to... You know what? Let's put a torch right there. I want this area pretty lit up. I don't want them to be able... I don't want the googlies to be able... to be encouraged to come inside here. So let me close that. Oh, I do have a little bit of an opening here, don't I? Let's do this. Let's put a little cobble. No, let's put glass right there. That way we can tell by looking out this door if it's, you know, daylight. We've got a little bit more to see there. Oh. Let's put a little dirt on it for tonight. Just, you know, just keep them from coming in. Oh, it's not gonna, is it? Oh, that's no good. Okay, that'll keep them from coming in. It's unsightly, and I will have to dig through it to be able to see out, but for right now, until I get some iron doors, I want to be able to get out that direction, but I don't want them to be able to get in. Okay, so let's finish the tour. I've got a place to sleep. I've got some food growing. I've got a tree garden outside. I've got some furnaces set up and stocked with fuel. I've got a few miscellaneous things that I've created. Let's go ahead and put this glass up. And I am collecting, you know, some coal and stuff like that that I'm going to need for my furnaces. I've got some precious minerals up here and building materials down here. Down here, I plan either another grow room back in here or maybe a big, deep storage area because that's going to be really close to the exit. And my project, the things I'm going to be building, are going to be out there and out this direction. So I may put a storage room right in there. Let's take you down to the mine. Do I have everything I need? Oh wait, no, let's offload some of this stuff so I have room to carry stuff back. Let me just do that. I'll be right back. Okay, I've put everything up, and I've set up what I want to take down with me. I definitely want some picks. Now, I do have 3 iron picks, and the reason for that is you can only mine diamonds with an iron pick or better. And I believe you get more out of the redstone with the iron pick over the wood pick, but I'm not entirely sure of that, so don't quote me. So I am going to take down 2 stone picks and 3 iron picks, a couple of swords to defend myself in the event I find a cavern. I'm going to take down some materials for torches and at least 32 with me. Some wood in case I have a building project, a couple of cobblestone steps to help me step up. Some food. Oh, I don't need that poppy, but I guess it won't hurt anything. What I'm trying to do is open up my inventory so that I have room to bring stuff back. I'm going to be down there mining, and although I have a staging area, I want to be able to bring stuff back. So I've got an apple in the event I, you know, get a little bit hungry. I've got some other stuff in my inventory. Oops. Now let's show you what we did. So basically, let's stop right here for a second. Here's what I did. Every about 5 or 6 blocks, I cut in behind me and dropped a torch. That keeps this tunnel lit up. Now, it's only 1 around, so a spider can't drop in on me. And since the googlies can't use ladders, I'm in pretty good shape. Now, if I'm not mistaken, there's a cave off that way. I did find a little bit of iron ore there, but I dug down until my F3 on the PC said I was at level 10 on the Y. So see XYZ right there? I'm at the 10th level, which is I've been told, I haven't experienced this firsthand until now. I've been told that this is where all the really good minerals are. So I've come in every 2 blocks and I've cut a little channel and I've begun mining down there, and this is where I've gotten the cobblestone and the iron ore that you've seen, and some of the redstone. Now I've only done 2 shafts, and this is the one I was working on. See, I left a torch in front of it to let myself know. So we're going to head down here, and I'm going to show you what I found that I'm so excited about. Now, you know, this is one of the ways that I mine. I headed off in here because when I got down here, I heard a bunch of googlies. Oh, hear them? So I know there's a cavern nearby. So I left this marked in case they were quiet next time I came by. I want to explore that cavern, just not yet. I need a few more tools. Okay, and look at what I found! Diamonds! I did want to wait and mine those while we were on camera, So you could see this is the very first diamond of the series, and I wanted you to be able to see it. Now I do need an iron pickaxe. Oh, look, more than one, yay! In order to mine these. Otherwise, you know, they'll break. They'll just destroy the mineral. I won't be able to use it. So, looky there. Oh, and this pops right through to my other tunnel. So that's okay. I'm going to leave that there, but I am going to drop a torch right here. Okay, we'll continue down there in a minute. There is some more down here. I believe there's redstone I left down here. Nope, I'm sorry. It was the other tunnel. So right here. Oh, yeah. So I found some more redstone and lapis. So I am hearing the googlies. So there's a cavern nearby me. I am gonna wanna explore that. But like I said, I want a little better tools. I want my iron sword. I want to be able to really cut through them in the event I find them. And ideally, I'd like to have a bow. Skeletons spawn in the dark, and they have some range on their tools. And if I don't have a similar range, well, I'm not going to be able to get near them until they take me, you know, before they take me out, and that's not good. So I'm just going to go mine this ore. Listen, lots of coal. And that's really all I've been doing. I'll just continue cutting channels up and down here, harvesting some materials, and then I'll check back in with you for the next major project. You know what, why don't we discuss that? Look at this, there's iron ore right there. Okay, I'm going to mark, this is where I'm at. And we're going to head down here, and I'm going to show you a couple things that I have planned. And then I'll go mine some more, and we'll come back and start building them. Oh yeah, I forgot about this. Let's grab this on the way up. Nothing else there. Okay, now I do like to kind of fill in behind myself to let myself know, you know, I found something here. But I don't want to let the googlies spawn in. And if I do leave it open like that, because I suspect there may be something else in there, or I heard something, then I will leave a torch in there to light it up. Now let's head back up to the surface. Oh, you know, let's offload some of this. Check this out. I've got some iron ore. Let's start some more smelting. And I've got some redstone to take upstairs. That's the good news. Okay, oops, let's go upstairs. Goodness, hear that noise? I think a skeleton is dying outside, is what it sounds like. Oh yeah, it's just becoming dawn. Now, I put a couple of windows in. I like being able to see out before I walk outside, especially when, you know, this area is kind of dark. I haven't scaffolded up and put some lights up there, and I probably need to. I did plant some trees, and that's gonna make it a little darker, which was probably not a good idea. But I wanted to be able to harvest wood right outside my door. I think I left my axe inside. Let's go ahead and grab my axe. If I'm going to go outside and give you a tour and discuss what we're going to do, if I come across a tree, I want to be able to cut it down. Oh, look, let's put the diamonds in the precious jewels case. These are the first. Oops. What'd I do? Did I put them in there? I did. Good grief. They go in this one. So I'm going to have my precious metals here and my gems here. I've got some lapis. Now, lapis we'll use in spelling and crafting enchantments, so I want to collect as much of that as I can. Now, I know in prior versions of the game, it really didn't have a purpose, but now all the enchantments really are kind of focused on that. Speaking of enchantments, I really probably should get outside and find myself some sugar cane and move it over here around my little lagoon. I'm going to need a lot of sugar cane for books. I need books for bookshelves, and I need bookshelves to make my enchantments work. Okay, so did I grab my, I did grab my axe. Let's go outside and let's show you a couple of plans that I have. Let's grab the sword. Now, I know I said when I started this series originally that I wanted to keep it pure. I wanted to go with vanilla Minecraft. But I gotta tell you, I installed a packet, you know, because, you know, hey, I'm a geek. I installed a texture pack that really makes this stuff out here just pop, just really, it's just gorgeous. So what I may do is create a video, and how about you guys let me know if this is what you want. I may get a realistic texture pack, install it, and do all that on camera so you can see how to do that for yourselves. The texture packs are really, they're just gorgeous, and I don't think they necessarily take away anything from the experience. In other words, you know, I'm not modding to add a feature like the ability to, you know, mine something or have something that's not normally in the game. I'm just going to improve the detail. Now, I tell you what, let's do this. Let me pause right here, and I'll put the other texture pack on, and I'll show you, and then you can vote. And I'll put it back. We'll continue until I hear from everybody. We'll continue playing vanilla Minecraft. But let me show you what it looks like. Oh, I just wanted to grab those before they fell. Okay, so pause and come back to the game. Okay, so this is Dataless 822. This is his texture pack that he created. And do you just see how much definition there is? I mean, this becomes really pretty gorgeous. I mean, look at how it changes the window frame. The cobblestone to me is just much more attractive. The torches are more realistic. I'm really loving the texture of this world. I think it kind of changes the gaming experience without actually modifying the game. So here's what I want you to do. Use the comments down below and let me know, should I keep the high definition texture pack on for the rest of this series, or is vanilla Minecraft what you really want to see in the way of textures? So why don't you let me know, and I'll do whatever everybody votes for. So you know what, I'm going to leave the tour here. I know I said I was going to come out here and show you what I had planned, but we'll leave that for another video. I've been running for a few minutes now. We'll make the next video a tour and a discussion of what I plan to do outside. The automated farms that I want to have, I want to be able to raise pigs and cows and sheep and have them right here where I can get to them, and maybe they'll, you know, I can collect the meat and material and leather and wool and send it through hoppers into chests automatically. I mean, I am a geek and I have a few things in mind, so I want to introduce you to my plan, my big vision, in the next video. So till then, this is the Geeky Minecrafter signing off.